a time, a group of travelers, on their way to Canterbury, were subjected to the wife of Bath and her endless tale. She was deaf in one ear, and she was dedicated to the fiber arts. And when it came to the church, she was a...
Basically, she's a...
Yes. She was also fond of hats, by habit wearing a particularly large one.
Don't forget her red socks.
Oh my gosh, of course, her socks. She had a lot of worldly experience.
Basically, she got around.
Experience. No other authority is good enough ground to stand on, and enough for me.
Wait, stop. She's had 5 husbands. Let's just go to the tale.
In ancient times, in the days of good King Arthur, there was a knight who committed an atrocious crime. King Arthur wanted his immediate death, however, the good Queen Guinevere took pity on him. Of either life or death, which will it be? I grant you your life if you are able to give me a statement of what we women most desire. So the young knight began his quest. He had a year and a day to figure out what women want. He asked every maiden and searched high and low for the most difficult answer. Some said fame and riches. Some said honor. And some said love. But because everyone had a different answer, he knew none were correct. In despair, he turned towards home. A day or two away from the castle, he came upon some ladies dancing. Suddenly, they vanished, leaving behind a woman of such ugliness, he could barely look at her. To his surprise, she rose and came towards him.
Good sir, I know the answer to which you seek, but I won't give you the answer unless you give me my heart's desire.
Out of desperation, the knight agreed, and returning to the palace, they sought a meeting with the fair queen. Sir Knight, have you the answer? What do women want?
My queen, what women want is not fame, nor do they want love ever after. What women want is sovereign power.
Very good, Sir Knight. You are free. And the good knight went back to the ugly woman, offering whatever she desired.
What I desire is a husband.
Though this surprises the knight and disgusts him, he agrees. Days pass, and though the knight is unhappy with his ugly spouse, he keeps his promise. His unhappiness, though, doesn't go unnoticed by his spouse.
Darling husband, what is the cause of your unhappiness? Although I have kept my promise, I wish you were more comely to look upon.
I am sorry to hear that. If you would prefer that I am beautiful, I fear that I could not stay true. My ugly visage keeps me true to you. I will let you decide, though, what you want.
The knight, confronted with this pronouncement, thought about the offer and answered his wife. For he respected her by this time, if not loved her.
My loving wife, though it calls sorrow to my heart, I will let you decide, for I want you to be happy.
With this, the knight and his wife went to bed, knowing he would be stuck forever with an ugly yet loyal wife. Rising early with the sun, the knight turns over to find his wife, now fairer than the sunrise.
My wife, what has happened?
For you, my husband, I am now beautiful, because you gave me the choice. Now I am yours forever. The end.